condition that is often misdiagnosed, or we're talking about like an underactive thyroid. I'm very interested in this. Here with more is Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing. So this whole underactive thyroid thing is misdiagnosed for a lot of people who, what, complain of being tired all the time?
Fatigue, depression, pain of any kind. That could be muscle, that could be joint.
Huh.
Thinning hair, dry skin, weak nails are all symptoms, constipation. I can go on and on. You can have some of them or a few of them.
Okay.
But over 80% of people that have, quote, normal thyroid labs have underactive thyroid gland.
Underactive thyroid gland. So you go to your regular doctor, they're like, oh, well, your thyroid looks fine, and you walk away thinking, well, what's wrong with me?
Right, right.
Oh, okay.
And patients are often surprised when I say, before I get to know them very well, oh, your thyroid's too low, we need to work on that. And they'll sit on the edge of the couch and say, I've been to every doctor thinking it's my thyroid, but told it's not. Why? Because my labs look normal. Normal and optimal are two entirely different things when it comes to health and well-being.
Okay, let's take a look in case you're wondering, because we hear about thyroid all the time. You know, you've heard the word, and there it is. It's
right.
Like in your throat.
So the thyroid's right in the throat. And so you see the hypothyroid gland tells the pituitary to secrete this hormone called TSH. Thyroid Stimulating Hormone. That is the lab that everybody diagnoses, or conventional medical doctors, I should say, prescribe thyroid off of. So if that TSH is high, that means the hormones, T3 and T4 in the bottom of the screen, which is the hormones that the thyroid secretes, is low. That will go up if the thyroid's underacting. In overt pathology.
Okay.
But there are, like I said, 80% or more people that I treat that have, quote, normal labs, that once we optimize their thyroid hormone in their body, which means the defect could be at the receptor in the body, so the brain has no idea about this.
Oh, so it's releasing correctly, but it's not accepting it.
That's
correctly.
Right. Okay. That's correct. So the thyroid hormone circulating is not doing the job that it should.
Huh.
And what's interesting about the thyroid gland is, or thyroid hormone, I should say, is that it has one job in the body, period, and that job is to turn the cells on. So it's our memory, it's our mood, it's our heart, it's our digestive tract, it's our bone health. So we want to make sure that our cells are doing their job, and that's what thyroid does. It's the light switch to the cells. So if a thyroid was removed for cancerous reasons or other reasons,
right,
and a patient didn't take thyroid, within 2 weeks or so, they would pass away because their cells stop functioning.
So it's obviously a very important little guy there.
It's essential for life.
Okay, so getting back to the thyroid, and you say that you're often misdiagnosed. So how do you know that it's more than just a misdiagnosis,
right,
that there's something actually wrong?
So it's fabulous you asked that question. So thyroid's been on the market since 1893. Until 1975, it was used to treat symptoms only. There was no blood test whatsoever. When TSH came on the market in 1975, the people that were on thyroid had to cut their thyroid by 80%. All of those patients felt worse, wanted more, but in conventional medicine, that was the standard of care at that point.
Huh.
So we realized that when you treat the symptoms, regardless of what the labs say, if there is no risks, like increased heart rate, some people will get, feeling jittery, that's too much thyroid. So you want to watch your patient, obviously, but I watch the paper last.
All right, so we talked about some of the symptoms, which were fatigue, which I think a lot of women that I know would say, yeah, that's how I've been feeling.
Right.
You said depression. You kind of mentioned some things here. Pain of some sort.
Any kind of pain. And that pain could be fibromyalgia pain. It could be arthritic pain. It could be any type of pain whatsoever. If we have chronic pain because from exercise, our body's not recovering well.
Does thyroid affect your metabolic rate?
Absolutely.
Like how quickly,
100%.
You know, maybe weight gain, and you're like, I'm doing everything right, but I can't seem to
right.
feel.
Yes. People think of thyroid as a weight loss pill. It's not, but it helps your metabolism be more efficient. So yes, you're going to burn fat more efficiently, but it's not a weight loss pill. But those with low thyroid will tend to gain weight.
Are there other tests besides a blood test to know that you think maybe it's your thyroid besides the symptoms too?
The TSH, which we spoke about, is one test, but we have to look at the circulating T3, the circulating T4, and the reverse T3, and that gives us a better picture of what's happening with that patient.
Okay, so you brought a lot of things here. Is this all for things you can do in case your thyroid is underactive?
Underactive, that's correct. Well, first you want to know if it is by blood, and sometimes it's overtly, and I'm surprised that there are more than less patients with overt hypothyroidism. But then we have to look at another gland that balances it, which we'll talk about a little bit later, and that is the adrenal glands, because if they're not working properly and you give thyroid, the person's going to feel worse. So the symptoms being fatigue, that might be coming from the adrenals. So we'll bring it all together with testing and treatment.
You have to know if it's one or the other. So
that's
don't
right.
jump out right now and start getting thyroid medicine.
That's right.
Thinking, oh, that'll help me feel more alert.
Yes, that's correct.
You don't want to do this without.
So we'll be real specific about understanding how do we know the difference.
Okay, between adrenal and the thyroid.
Right.
Which one is maybe not acting.
That's
up,
correct.
Up
and
to
how
par.
To balance them together. which is so important.
Okay, so Dr. Ramsey is going to come back, and we're going to talk about that topic a little bit later on in the show, so don't go anywhere, because I think a lot of people probably are struggling with this and and don't know what else is wrong, because their doctor said everything looked fine.
That's right.
So if you want more, that happens a lot. Mm-hmm. If you want more information, of course, on Dr. Ramsey or the Center for Natural Healing, you can go to our website, azfamily.com/your life, or you can always dial our hotline. When we come back, Dr. Ramsey has natural treatments for low thyroid, but before we take a break, welcome back. I'm here with Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing, finishing our discussion on underactive thyroid,
right?
And what we can do about it. Now we kind of know what it is and what the symptoms are, but what can we do?
Right. First, we have to make some diagnoses. Well, first, you know, we say, how many of the symptoms do you have? Okay. Then we start diagnosing. There's a pioneer in the field, Dr. Rhoda Barnes, who wrote a book, Hypothyroidism, The Unsuspected Illness. And it's a beautiful book anybody could get. And his main thing was body temperature.
Oh.
And if your body temperature orally is any lower than 98.6, you probably have a low thyroid.
That's interesting. So take your temperature first and see what it's at.
That's right. So that's why I brought the thermometer.
Okay.
So testing our body temperature. Then we have to know, does this body tend to gain weight or lose weight? Because some hypothyroid patients will go one way or the other. If the patient's tending to gain weight, that's usually hypothyroidism. So we want to do a blood test. But you have to do a full blood test, not just a TSH, or you'll miss it completely.
Okay.
Then,
and that's what you were saying, a lot of doctors don't do the full blood test.
That's right. If a patient tends to lose weight, you may know people who have a lot of stress and lose weight, then we know the adrenal is a predominant gland that's low functioning. So anyone with any kind of stress in their life, the adrenal glands are not at their best.
Okay.
So the adrenal glands we diagnose through testing. We can do a blood test, which measures DHEA. We do a saliva test, which measures isocort. Isocort. And we do a urine test that measures iodine.
So this is all for adrenal?
That's all for adrenal. That's correct.
Okay.
And so then you get a map. So once you get the results back, you get a map to say what time of day are they most deficient in these hormones. And so you can map it out. So people say they're mostly tired at 4 p.m. It's going to show up on the test.
Okay. So now that you know that it's thyroid
or adrenal,
what can you take? And is all thyroid medication like prescription medication?
So some is and some aren't.
Okay.
So the bioidentical thyroid that I prefer is, my favorite is Nature Thyroid. It comes in so many different dosages. It's desiccated. That's the one that was on the market for all the years before Synthroid came on the market.
Right. Okay. I've heard of Synthroid.
And Synthroid was just FDA approved in 2002. It was on the market patented for so long, but just was FDA approved. But this has been on the market since 1898. Okay. So it's desiccated, which means it's raw bovine thyroid that's glandular, dried, freeze-dried, and sterilized, made into thyroid that's identical to our bodies. So how do we dose it? We start with a low dose just to see, and some people feel nothing. And then we go the next week or next month, depending on the fragility or strength of the patient, we increase it until we get to a point where we have symptom resolution. Once we have symptom resolution, then we look at their blood work, and if their T3 and T4, which are the hormones we're looking at, are flagged high, that's their optimal. Normal is not enough for them.
And then is that something they stay on for the rest of their lives?
They would stay on it for the rest of their lives. Some people try to get off after between 1 and 2 years, and that's possible for some people, not all, because what you're doing is you're tonifying the gland, you're resting the gland, then as you come off slowly, it's creating a lot more, and the receptors are receiving it more efficiently.
And if it's adrenal, what do you take?
And if it's adrenal, if it's adrenal and you take thyroid, you will feel worse. So that's a key. And this is after 16 years of practice, after watching patients. I've made patients feel worse by giving thyroid too soon. We have to back up and support the adrenal glands. So the two main hormones are DHEA, which a lot of people have heard of, which can be taken oral or sublingual, and then isocort, which is adrenal glandular extract. Okay. And so you take those two, and a lot of people feel beautiful energy. Their metabolism is much stronger. You put a little thyroid on top of that, and then you have the whole picture covered.
So really, if you are feeling this way and you suspect it's one of these two things, you have to go through these tests so you know exactly what the map is?
Some yes, some no.
Okay.
Sometimes it is so obvious to me when I'm with a patient that I will just do a clinical trial.
Okay.
And what I say is, if you feel hyper or shaky, you're on too much thyroid, just back off.
Okay. Very interesting. So if that's maybe what's been going on with you and you've gone to your regular doctor and they're like, everything's fine, you might want to check into it a little bit
deeper. It's very common. It's extremely common.
Thank you, Dr. Ramsey. You're not going